Do you ever find yourself wondering what sets Formula One cars apart from regular automobiles? From the speed to the engineering behind the machines, there's a lot that separates them. One of the most important aspects of F1 racing is the brake system, and Red Bull Racing has become a leader in this technology. In this video, we'll explore the engineering behind Red Bull's F1 success and look at the brakes that make it all possible. Get ready to take a deep dive into the incredible world of Formula One racing. Before getting into this video, make sure to like and subscribe to our channel, F1 Racing, for more updates. So let's go. The braking system in Formula One cars is an incredibly complex technology that requires a delicate balance of many components. It includes the brake discs, pads, calipers, hydraulic systems, and a mechanical slash electrical hybrid device called the Motor Generator Unit Kinetic, or MGUK. The MGUK gathers energy from heat produced by the brakes while they're in use and converts it into electricity for various uses. The ECU, or engine control unit, provides live information on the brake pressure and temperature, which is monitored by both the driver and race engineers to ensure optimum performance is maintained. The hydraulic system provides pressurized fluid to activate the calipers so that they can grip against the discs, providing significant levels of deceleration. Excess hydraulic pressure not used to brake goes into the MGUK, which is then converted into electricity for other uses in the car. The rear brakes don't have to do as much work as their front counterparts due to weight distribution on non-braking and braking conditions, and can thus be set with a little less pressure. Heat is managed and dissipated by the brake discs, which have to be able to withstand temperatures up to 1000 degrees Celsius. If the MGUK were to fail, the car can no longer brake effectively. Similarly, if there were an issue with the brake-by-wire system, the car would become dangerously unpredictable. However, due to its advanced construction materials, the F1 brake system offers drivers phenomenal stopping power. Formula One teams use a variety of sophisticated braking systems to ensure that their cars stop as quickly and safely as possible. Most Formula One teams use a combination of rear disc brakes, brake-by-wire systems, and adjustable brake bias balances. Rear disc brakes are comprised of two discs attached to the wheel hubs, while the brake-by-wire system is used to control the brake pressure applied to each wheel. Adjustable brake bias balances allow the driver to adjust the amount of pressure applied to either the front or rear brakes in order to optimize braking performance. The brake systems employed by Formula One teams are highly advanced and require frequent maintenance and calibration in order to remain at peak performance on race day. All of these elements combined are essential for a successful Formula One braking system. The sophisticated braking technology employed by the top F1 teams is what separates them from their competitors and allows them to push their cars to the limits of speed and performance. The team at Red Bull Racing has continually pushed boundaries in terms of brake technology, developing advanced systems and materials to reduce brake fade and wear. This engineering expertise has been a major factor in the team's success, allowing their drivers to effectively manage their speed and stay ahead of the competition. Red Bull Racing has not only developed brake technology that is reliable and consistent, but also designed systems that are lightweight and efficient, allowing them to gain a competitive edge on the track. This dynamic combination of advanced engineering and high-precision components is what makes Red Bull Racing the brake technology leader in Formula One racing. F1 drivers have long been praising the brake system of Formula One cars. Some famous F1 drivers, such as 7-time world champion Lewis Hamilton, 4-time world champion Sebastian Vettel, and 2-time world champion Fernando Alonso have all praised the braking power of Formula One cars and how they allow them to have precise control in tight corners and during intense braking moments. Hamilton has said that the brakes on modern F1 cars are incredibly powerful and allow them to have complete control. Vettel has also noted that the brakes provide great confidence and help them reach higher top speeds. Alonso, meanwhile, praised the strength of brake performance in races as well as in testing conditions, noting that they allow the driver to make a difference and be competitive. With such positive comments from some of the world's best F1 drivers, it's clear why Red Bull's brake system has been so successful in the sport. The components of the brake system in a Formula One car are designed to help it achieve maximum stopping power. The main component is the master cylinder, which uses hydraulic pressure to control the brake calipers on each wheel. The master cylinder unit provides the power necessary for deceleration and helps regulate the braking force evenly between all four wheels. The electronic control unit is responsible for monitoring and responding to driver inputs in real time, which helps adjust the brake balance as needed. To limit hydraulic pressure not used to brake, there is an accumulator pump system in place that also helps reduce weight where possible. Additionally, due to their smaller size and less weight, the rear brakes don't need to do as much work as the front brakes. Finally, disc brakes are used and designed to manage heat by dissipating it away from the brake components. The discs also reduce the risk of failure of the MGUK and brake-by-wire system. These components all come together to help create a powerful braking system used in Formula One cars. Heat management is critical to the success of Formula One brakes, and this is where discs come in. Discs absorb heat through friction when the brake pedal is applied, which helps to disperse it away from other components in the system. The materials used for these discs are designed to allow for maximum thermal conductivity so that even at temperatures as high as 1000 degrees Celsius, the heat is dissipated quickly and efficiently. The discs are also designed with slots that help to act as cooling channels, allowing a greater volume of air to be drawn in and provide additional cooling. Additionally, discs can be attached to fans or ducts so that air is forced over them during braking, further increasing their ability to dissipate heat. All of these aspects work together to ensure that Formula One brakes remain effective, even when subjected to extreme conditions. The MGUK and the brake-by-wire system are two components of the Formula One braking system that carry a risk of failure. The MGUK is responsible for harvesting energy from the brakes during deceleration, as well as providing extra torque to the rear axle during acceleration. If this component fails, either the car will ineffectively harvest energy, or it will not be able to accelerate at low speeds. The brake-by-wire system is responsible for controlling hydraulic pressure, and if this fails, a driver can lose the ability to control brake bias or apply brakes altogether. Such failures are rare due to the robust quality of modern F1 parts, but they can still be catastrophic in the case of a race. It is therefore essential that these components are regularly monitored and maintained by engineers to ensure safe operation. Overall, while the risk of failure is low, it is important to recognize such failures as possible consequences and take preventive measures accordingly. Setting the brake balance or bias involves redistributing braking force between the car's front and rear brakes, based on the weight of the car. Ideally, each brake should be doing just enough work to manage the load it's dealing with. At rest, an F1 car's weight is distributed roughly 45 to 55, meaning 55% in the front and 45% in the rear, supported by the rear tires. Under heavy braking, the weight shifts forward to as much as 55-45, so drivers will tend to set a brake bias to about 55% towards the front brakes. Too much front brake bias and the fronts will grip too tightly and lock up wheels, causing understeer. Too much rear bias and the back wheels can lock and cause the car to become unstable and spin. Drivers can adjust brake bias between corners from within their cockpit, but this is only allowed while the car is off the brakes. Safety considerations must also be taken into account when setting brake balance, as locking either in front or back wheels means that it's impossible to turn the car. As a result, drivers must be careful not to bias too much weight towards the front or rear brakes. Ultimately, setting the right brake balance and weight distribution on non-braking versus braking is key for successful F1 racing. It requires experience, skill, and knowledge of how cars handle under various conditions in order to master this technique. Once it is mastered, the driver can look forward to increased speed and safety during the races. Managing temperature and degradation is an essential part of the F1 braking system's success. To ensure the brakes are in the perfect temperature region for each braking zone, a combination of high-quality materials and design must be utilized to keep the brake discs from becoming too hot or cool. Ideally, this should result in all brakes delivering their maximum force when needed, and all wheels locking in unison if the brakes are pushed too hard. As well as controlling the temperature of the discs, managing degradation throughout a session is also key to keeping the brakes functioning correctly. Degradation occurs when heat builds up within the discs, which can cause warping, cracking, or scoring on the surface, ultimately leading to brake failure. Therefore, proper maintenance and management of temperature and degradation is critical for ensuring a successful race, something Red Bull has mastered over the years. To achieve the perfect temperature region, drivers can adjust brake bias between corners from within their cockpit while the car is off the brakes. This enables them to keep temperatures in check, as well as reduce wear on the discs during a race. This careful balance of temperature, wear, and grip makes Red Bull Racing's F1 braking system one of the most reliable on the grid. Front wheel locking is a major issue for F1 drivers, as it can cause the car to become unstable and spin out of control if too much pressure is applied. To avoid front wheel locking, drivers need to make sure that their brake bias is set correctly, with the optimum amount of weight distributed between the front and rear tires. Too much front bias and the front will grip too tightly and lock the wheels, causing heavy understeer, and too much rear bias, meanwhile, can cause the back wheels to lock and become unstable. Drivers need to adjust their brake bias between corners from within the cockpit while not braking in order to maintain a perfect balance. By taking this precaution, F1 drivers can avoid the chance of wheel locking and maintain a stable car during heavy braking. Locking the front wheels of an F1 car has several key benefits. First, it helps to keep the car stable and prevent a spin during heavy braking. Secondly, by locking the front wheels together, the weight is shifted slightly forward, which helps reduce understeer and improves cornering performance. Additionally, utilizing the front brakes to their maximum capacity allows the driver to stop at a shorter distance, thus improving time on track. Finally, locking all four wheels reduces the amount of heat generated by the brakes, which can help prevent degradation and ensure that they perform at their best during long race sessions. Overall, having an efficient brake system with appropriate bias is essential for any successful F1 team. The advanced materials used in F1 brakes, such as carbon fiber and ceramic composites, have tremendous potential for stopping power. These materials are lightweight and extremely durable, making them ideal for the rigorous demands of F1 racing. Carbon fiber is strong enough to withstand extreme temperatures without degrading, while ceramic materials provide superior heat resistance and increased braking force. With the right combination of materials, F1 brakes can provide reliable and sustainable braking power that can give drivers an advantage on the track. By using advanced materials in their brake system, Red Bull Racing is able to stay ahead of the competition and extend their lead in the championship standings. The importance of utilizing the latest brake technology for optimal performance in F1 racing cannot be overstated. The newest braking systems are designed to provide maximum braking power and efficiency, as well as improve safety for drivers. Not only do these systems allow racers to stop quickly, but they also help keep the wheels from locking up during hard braking. This reduces the risk of skidding and increases the chances of a successful race. The latest brake technology also helps to reduce brake fade, meaning the drivers can count on their brakes to perform reliably over an entire race. This is critical for any F1 driver who needs to be able to confidently control the car and make split-second decisions under intense pressure. Ultimately, the latest brake technology provides F1 drivers with an extra edge when it comes to performance and safety. In 2023, Formula One is set to implement a new brake technology that has the potential to revolutionize the sport. This innovative system will use electric actuation instead of mechanical cables or hydraulics, which will give drivers precise control and improved responsiveness. In addition to providing more efficient braking power and smoother modulation, this new brake setup will reduce the amount of heat transferred to the brake discs and calipers, resulting in less wear and tear on these components. Additionally, it'll reduce unsprung mass, which will improve handling and maneuverability. Overall, this new technology has the potential to provide significant performance benefits to Formula One teams and drivers alike. The engineering behind Red Bull's F1 success is truly remarkable. By keeping their brakes in the optimal temperature region and setting appropriate brake bias, they've been able to achieve incredible performance out of the cars. They've pushed the boundaries of what we thought was possible in a Formula One car and continue to innovate with each passing year. It's a testament to the dedication and expertise of the Red Bull Racing team and their engineers, who have tirelessly worked to refine and perfect the braking system in their F1 cars. In the competitive world of Formula One, even the slightest advantage can make a significant difference. Red Bull's ability to keep their brakes operating in the optimal temperature range and adjust the brake bias to suit different track conditions has undoubtedly given them an edge over their rivals. As technology and engineering continue to advance, it'll be exciting to see what other innovations the Red Bull Racing team will bring to the table in the future. One thing is for sure, their dedication to pushing the limits of what's possible in Formula One is unparalleled, and we can expect to see more remarkable feats from them in the years to come. So, until next time, goodbye, and thanks for watching.